comprised of family individuals who share a common interest in community involvement, agriculture, and conservation and rural issues. Programs, projects, and activities offered by the Grange very much reflect the interests of the members and the talents and the special focus that we have on volunteerism and family activities. The Norfolk Grange has enjoyed a long and prosperous history here in Norfolk, from pancake breakfast to educational programs, to musicians, to horse and field hay rides through town at twilight. The Grange has done a lot of programs here, kind of, I guess you could say, interest every palate. The National Grange came into being in 1867 as a result of a need for folks that live in the rural communities to have a unified voice. Because of the independent and scattered nature of Raritan folks, they found that coordinating their activities was very difficult. And railroads and river companies were taking advantage of local growers and producers. So Oliver Hudson Kelly, the founder of the Grange, and his friends organized the National Grange as a fraternal family organization. And it is one of the oldest organizations in the country. We have effective lobbying efforts in almost every state and have been instrumental in bringing forth a lot of new concepts. But the heart and soul of every Grange is community service. And through strong local leadership and innovation, the Grange contributes to the quality of life of the community it serves. We have guest speakers, we do workshops, educating youth, we have our annual essay contest. This year we have almost 400 essays. And as a community service organization, our members really know the value of volunteerism, and that's why we're here this evening. It's for this reason that each year, the Grange chooses an individual to recognize because they've made their mark on the landscape of this community. We know them by face a lot of times before we know them by name because we see them so often, and we can count on them when they really need to get something done. They are the individuals that have withstood the test of time and helped to sculpt our town into a community. And as a community, the Grange takes great pleasure in recognizing individuals that exemplify the basic precepts of our order. We are recognizing an outstanding individual tonight for their service and commitment to the town and their volunteerism to the community, and we hope that you'll join us in recognizing them. And hopefully, our honoree this evening will recognize some of their accomplishments. Our honoree this evening has been a longtime resident of the town of Norfolk. They've been actively involved in many town and community activities and spent many hours volunteering their time for the betterment of the community. Tonight's honoree for the Community Citizen of the Year Award has been described by friends as hardworking, dedicated, and willing to go the extra mile. Individuals who have worked with them have described them as a consummate facilitator who is able to create positive atmospheres of consensus. Tonight's award recipient attended Dean and Stonehill College, obtained a bachelor's degree in liberal arts. Using her talents as a careful listener and an advocate for those who needed a voice, she began building a new hope with women who were victims of abuse. Her talents were well utilized as she worked as director of volunteers, as a parent aid, and assisted in the visitation center. Her caring attitude won the hearts of many who worked with her as they struggled through difficult family times. She left New York to attend Leslie College to obtain a master's degree in education with a focus on peaceful schools. The focus of her studies was consensus building and bringing groups together to accomplish tasks. Then 9/11 occurred, and it struck at the heart of every American. Early on, our honoree recognized the need for the community of Norfolk to create something that would serve as a monument to those who lost their lives on that day. Her foresight and organizational skills drew together community resources and focused on one goal. The 9/11 committee was formed, and the community joined forces under one banner, working towards one common goal, and the rest is town history. It gives Norfolk Grange great pride to announce the recipient of this year's Community Citizen Award, Mrs. Bonnie Dittrich. son Matt and his wife Kim. Matt is Benjamin Hinton.
Yes.
And brothers and sisters, our Carl and Ann are here, and also Lisa, who just very quick, mom, just over the office. So family members, thank you so much for coming. Escort our audience to the master station. If you both would please rise, we'll be escorted.
Service
being a member of a service organization like the Lions or like the Grange is not the sense of accomplishment that you get when you do something for the public or the public good. It's more fundamental than that. The nicest thing is the people you meet along the way. You meet the nicest people. You meet people who are selfless, people who share their love in their hearts with others, people who are rewarded with only a smile on another's face. People like those of you in this room. People like Ronnie Dittrich. Robert Kennedy once said, some people see things as they are, and some people are. I dream things that never were, and say, why not? After 9/11, Bobby said, why not? Why not remember those who gave their lives? Why not remember the families of those who died? Why not place a symbol of that event right here in Norfolk? Not only did she ask, she made it happen. When I was in college, I learned that idealism was not just a dream, but rather idealism was to dream and then do. Well, he did hurt with that idealist who dreamt and then did. And along the way, he made the community proud, proud of her, proud of ourselves, for a demonstration of our sense of purpose. We follow her example of showing our outrage over what happened by showing our love. We follow her example of selflessness by vowing never to forget others and by leaving a memorial for our children and our children's children for generations to come. And in doing so, she brought a smile to all of us and put love in our hearts. We thank you, Bonnie, for your efforts, for your idealism, for your love, for your bringing our community together. Norfolk is proud to have you as its citizen, and we are very proud to have you as its citizen of the year. Thank you, and God bless you.
We also have some representatives here tonight from the Norfolk Community League, and representing them is Tracy Newman.
That was exciting.
Anyway, mine is briefing to the point. The Norfolk Community League extends a warm congratulations to you for receiving this award. You have made a tremendous impact on our town. We thank you for all you have done and continue to do, and we are so very proud. Bonnie spent a long time working at New Hope, and she impacted the lives of many people who were there. And to speak on behalf of New Hope is their development director, Mr. Dan Cohen.
So I want to do the other one first. I'm here also representing the Department of Social Services in the Attleboro Trenton area. Lynn Daxton, the health census best, and Rosalie Kearns as well, but I didn't get a chance to talk to her. But the Department of Social Services, which is an agency that we work deals with in a variety of things, has their big foster parent appreciation event tonight. And so none of them could be here. I worked for the State Department of Social Services for nearly 15 years prior to going to New Hope in 1990, and so they asked me since I would be coming to also say a word on behalf of them, that they appreciate the hard work and the wonderful facilitation. I heard that word, so it's a wonderful facilitator, that some of the work that Bonnie did with the Department of Social Services in her capacity was New Hope, so they appreciate that work. Now, on behalf of New Hope, I have to say, I feel like I can't do justice in this role, because Bonnie, I think it was back in 1989 that she became involved with New Hope, with that women's program. She was a volunteer with the Parent Aid program. She began working with the Parent Aid that became the Family Support Services program. She went back to the Battered Women's program. She worked with me for 2 years doing outreach services. The final year or two at New Hope, she did all kinds of presentations at schools as part of our education and training program. She she did almost everything in New Hope, is what it boils down to. And there's kind of no way to say, wow, and thank you enough for that. Many of us were certainly very sad, you know, and yet, and seeing her with her master's program, you know, grow and shift and develop additional and broader priorities than even New Hope, knowing all the while that the core values of helping women and children and helping to keep people safe was always at her heart, in her heart. So I'm here just trying to inadequately say thank you for the many years of service at New Hope. We certainly still miss you, come visit, whatever. We do have the first, most of the years that Bonnie was there, a long-time executive director. 3 years ago, next month, she retired, and so we've had a new executive director since then, and it wasn't too long after, maybe a year after, that Bonnie left New Hope. And it's been a challenging year. I've got human service agencies across the Commonwealth. I think we've turned the corner north and are back on solid ground despite some challenges for this year. But again, the years of service that Bonnie and I see Linda Hughes is here, and hopefully get a chance to say hi to her tonight, Bonnie. But was her lost many years of the carrying program. She probably could tell stories upon stories of the kind of impact that people Bonnie had on her. I can talk forever, my point was not to do that. Let me just add two things. One, if you notice mine, I'm wearing one of my favorite ties. I believe it was 5 Christmases ago that Vine gave me this tie, which has the word cool in different angles written in some of the boxes. Now, there's a little bit of unfinished business. If you recall, Vine, when you gave me this, I loved it immediately because I'm a lover of words. I love the word cool, and you are certainly a hopeful and grander approach to so many people. But I'm still waiting. I believe I said that I hope the following Christmas I get a tie with the word new on it, and I wear them both together. I still haven't gotten it. But that's okay. I've been wearing this one for many reasons. And the other thing is, as Bonnie knows, and as Scott knows, because he got me to come and sing, this is the second time I've seen him work on it. This is just a little attempt at a mini musical tribute to Bonnie. And I will end it. It's based on a very animal song called Pussy for Venice. That's just Bonnie. That's Bonnie Dittrich, deserving the praise by all for. Oh, hey, Bonnie, you are terrific. Bonnie, your passion is always in fashion. You help people and improve lives.
Where I can't memorize things and get the whole thing right out. Resolution, the town sponsored a event, our event for the first anniversary of the attack. She arranged to have an initial meeting at the town hall, January 2002. That initial meeting, about 90% of the board's organizations were represented. And while she tried, and under her direction, there were several subsequent meetings. Two memorial services were planned at September 11, 2002, as well as the design of a peace garden to be erected on the town hill. The centerpiece of the garden is a 6-foot-tall tower, depicting 12 figures of various walks of life with a bowl on the top. The base of the statue is in the form of a pentagon, and there's a star on the dome representing the Pennsylvania field, where a plane was crashed by passengers in order to prevent a further terrorist attack. The committee adopted the theme, "One World Related to Peace," and subsequently adopted the design of 50 points, a 6-grade crosswalk uniform, a t-shirt to be sold from the peace garden and the statue. The peace garden's flowers will also be funded by Mary Drew. While the house has spent many hours on these t-shirts to enable the project to go forward, but I think they still have some. They appreciate it. On September 11, 2002, on the bottom direction, while the water needed service commemorating the attack and memorializing the victims of attack, and on September 11, 2003, a memorial service was held on the town hill, at which time the statue and peace center were dedicated. The peace garden has not yet been erected, but water is still working on it, and hopefully the garden will be installed in the spring of 2005 after all the important construction of the central town has been completed. Water is probably being enough for the finishing of the project, and we are proud of Bonnie's suggestion and determination to place a permanent memorial to those who lost their lives as well as to real peace in the town of Rockville. We cannot bring back the victims of this attack, but we will not forget their sacrifice. We in Rockville have one teacher to thank for this. Thank you and good evening.
you might recognize the sculptor who created that, which is Michael Alfano. He's recognized for works such as Stand Up, Speak Out, and a sculptor of both the Holocaust Memorial and Ethics of Peace. And he's here tonight to also speak on Lauren's behalf. Michael.
Thank you for inviting me. It's a pleasure making this sculpture. It was just a very moving experience the whole time. And as a sculptor, I work the body hand in hand throughout the program, traveling the disparate worlds of art and politics, which don't always match very well. What obstacles arose that they often do with these kinds of projects, finally dressed them in their usual positive manner and with amazing fortitude that really brought the project to a beautiful completion. She's very warm and caring and generously expressed those emotions. When she first saw the small-scale statue in my garage, she was really just moved to tears, and as well when she saw the large one. And it was just really a statement that I was really doing my job and I was really creating something that was really moving and very important to everyone here at the Norfolk and throughout the area. It's truly been a pleasure to work with you, and I thank you for all that you've done.
On the one hand, we've enjoyed, or on the other hand, we've suffered through close to 60 different selections over the last 5 years, discussing, dissing, and dissecting our way through. We've had annual Oprah's recommendations, we read fiction, historical fiction, travelogues, a couple of classics, a couple of mysteries, a little of this author and a little of that author. We could possibly count on one hand the number of times the body has missed those monthly meetings over the last 5 years. She's an active participant in all of our rantings and ravings, sharing with them discussions, providing her worldly insight, her motherly know-how, and sharing her honest opinion with us. I would now like, if there are any other book club members from any of the four groups here, if you could just join me and congratulate and applaud one of our own, Citizen Bob Dittrich. We heard a little bit about the t-shirts, and I'm sure the family, did everybody get one for Christmas? we heard a little bit about the t-shirts, and we hear from some folks that were near and dear to that project, and that would be Mrs. Linda Belfour, and it was what was designed and used on the t-shirt.
Special evening, I would like to thank Bonnie not only for the wonderful thing that you did for our town, but also for including the schools in that process. It was a pleasure to serve on the committee with Bonnie. The word facilitator has been used already, and she certainly was a superb facilitator of the group. But I think the two adjectives that I can think of are inclusive and optimistic. I think that the way she facilitated the group, she made sure that each and every one of us had our feelings known. She asked for input from all of us. She asked for our opinions. And I think that was very important in the way that the group worked. And optimistic. I mean, she knew from the start that something wonderful was going to come as a result of this committee, and as a result, it did. And I think, you know, inclusion and optimism are two things that we certainly want to teach all of our school children, so it was a great lesson for them as well. Lizzie White is here, and she is the person who designed the t-shirt. It was one of the ways that the school children were included. There was a design contest, and our theme was One World United for Peace, which is another, I think Bonnie was the guiding force behind that, because she wanted to make sure that while we commemorated those who were victims of 9/11, we also went forward with optimism and worked towards peace. And Lizzie very creatively and artistically took up that challenge and created a wonderful design for a t-shirt. And it was, it sold very well, didn't it? We shouldn't want to ask tonight, Lizzie. But, so we'd like to thank Lizzie for being part of that process also. One thing that you did so willingly, and I'm sure your husband can attest to this, is the time you spent on the committee, the time planning for this. And so what we would like to do is from the children and the staff in our four public schools, we would like to present you with a little token to put in your bags, so that we hope that you'll be able to spend some time not just meeting around your pool, but spending time with your family, many of our meetings with the committee were held at Bonnie's home, and you'll be able to enjoy that, and it is a peace rose. So we think it's very fitting to commemorate these words. So thank you for all that you did for us, Bonnie.
Thank you.
to come see you to be a citizen of the year. She thought that was the most awesome thing. Rachel actually just met Bonnie a couple years ago, and she always, she called her Bonnie because she's just so cool. I'm actually here to represent the Lions, Norfolk Together, and Norfolk, and don't know if I'm wrong something. Norfolk is the head of the Santa Foundation, and really that's where, what we really wanted to focus on tonight, was just a can-do attitude of both Norfolk Together and the Santa Foundation. Bonnie joined Norfolk Together a couple of years ago, and for those of you who don't know, Norfolk Together helps the needy people here in Norfolk, and even in Long Island, the needy people here in Norfolk. And we help raise funds, and Bonnie is always at those meetings coming up with some new ideas and how we can raise funds, and how we might make those lives here in Norfolk just a little bit better. Like you said, Lions, we can just put a small smile on some of our faces and perhaps give them some hope. But in any event, Bonnie can always say, let's do this. Let's go to the transfer station and sell our raffle tickets. Let's talk room at Community Day. And then this year, she helped facilitate Norfolk Together and bring thoughtful women to our table to talk about how we could best bring gifts to families in Norfolk and surrounding communities. Without him leaving, he's just this very hilarious guy. We knew a lot of people over at the fire department as well. And she just helped us get together and just get organized in giving out gifts this past holiday season. And in fact, she went shopping, she and Scott adopted a family, and then Bob called her at the last minute, probably a week before Christmas, and said, you know, I need more gifts. And Bonnie was out there. So what one can say, which is very awesome, and I'm so privileged to know you. I was sitting here thinking about how I am just after 9/11, but I have no personal company, and I'm just so lucky to thank you, and Scott, and you are so lucky to have you in this town. Congratulations.
Thank you. she was proud of our creation of the title. And so I want you to know that she is very sad she couldn't be here this evening. Pat Michaels, we love you.
And also, on behalf of the Federated Church of Lombard, Pastor Tracy Franklin.
Deal with the individual, and in this case with Bonnie, on all the different projects and things that she's
worked on, that the message is heartfelt when it comes from the individuals that she's working. I want to thank you, and the Grange salutes you for your volunteerism and all your efforts on behalf of Norfolk. And we'd like to give you a few minutes if you'd like to address these folks. Thank you all.